Next up, we have the National Research Council of Canada's Industrial Research Assistance Program, or NRC IRAP. At its core, they help small and medium-sized businesses drive growth through innovation and technology, enabling them to compete in the global marketplace. They've also been a force in Canada's innovation system for over 70 years. I'd like to welcome Carl Miller to the stage to share more.
Thanks for that. Nice to see everyone here. Are we online as well? Perfect. Thanks for the introduction. I'm a client engagement advisor with the National Research Council's IRAP program. I'll try to make sure we don't have too much acronym soup that you can drown in here today. IRAP is short for the Industrial Research Assistance Program. We're part of the larger National Research Council Canada, not NRCan, but actually the National Research Council. NRC, founded in 1916, is currently about 3,500 people across the country, mostly in research institutes. IRAP is a small subset with approximately 350 people. IRAP celebrated 75 years this past January as a program. This last fiscal year, we invested over $450 million in innovative SMEs, or small to medium-sized enterprises. Basically, for us, that means under 500 employees. We also worked with over 9,000 firms last year, either through services, funding, or referrals. IRAP is a local, national program. We're part of the federal government. We have our own act of parliament that has built out the National Research Council. But I have 15 industrial technology advisors here in Calgary. We have ITAs in Edmonton, Red Deer, Calgary, Lethbridge, and it's the same across the country. All of our decisions are made locally. Nothing's actually decided in Ottawa in terms of who we work with and the projects that we do. We have staff in 106 communities across the country, and a cornerstone of the program is that we play a contact sport. Our ability to visit clients and on-site actually helps us to understand what their situation is, and we can get an understanding of the local flavor of what's going on for them. What's the IRAP advantage? Our program is not transactional. There's no such thing as an application form. Everything we do is based on relationships, okay? Our industrial technology advisors, or ITAs, are relationship builders. Those relationships are always local, with an understanding of the local landscape. We lever that local presence to build national networks that can be taken advantage of either on the research side, on a commercial side, or product development side. And then we've got smart money. Basically, money that can come in to be able to help at the right time for a company as it's growing. There are two main types of client-facing advisors at IRAP. I'm one of these, a client engagement advisor. My group of 18 across the country, we're from Victoria, BC to St. John's, Newfoundland. The 18 of us talk to 4,000 companies a year. We provide triage into IRAP to be able to help understand if companies are eligible and can work with IRAP. And then we have referrals into our networks for federal, provincial, and local programs, services, or funding. The other client-facing group within IRAP are industrial technology advisors. We have over 265 ITAs located across the country. This is always out of date because people are retiring and we're hiring all the time. I like to joke that the men and the women that make up this cohort either have gray hair or no hair. They're not fresh out of college, and typically they come from one of two backgrounds. They've actually done product development in a large technology company, think something on the scale of BlackBerry or Nortel, or they've started their own tech company from scratch. So they've built something out, they've made payroll, they've shipped product, they've dealt with warranty, and either they've actually, they've sold the company or they blew it up or some combination thereof. Each of those 265 ITAs advises approximately 20 companies a year, give or take a little bit. ITA relationships with these companies lasts typically 1 to 3 years. So what does IRAP do? IRAP's all about advice. We're there to try and provide that advice for companies to avoid the potholes and the pitfalls of product development and commercialization. And those kind of potholes and pitfalls that are going to waste time and money as the company is trying to do that. We can help on the technical side, we can help on the business side. We can refer clients to relevant and targeted programs that can complement what IRAP's doing at the same time. Alberta Innovates is a very strong partner that way. We're always connecting clients into their voucher programs because of the early stage that we play at. So we can be broken down into three segments: advice and expertise, network and strategy, and program funding. So IRAP programs, the projects that we do, we're basically there to be able to help companies hire technical horsepower to solve hard technical problems. The idea is to reduce the technical risk of the development by hiring smart people. We deliver a youth employment program for Employment and Social Development Canada. We also support international co-innovation projects for our clients, partners in Brazil, India, Israel, South Korea, Europe, and the EU. IRAP is industry agnostic. This chart helps to give a little bit of a breakdown as to who IRAP works with. Our mix of these sectors varies by region and province, depending on where they happen to be. It does also show that software is eating the world. Almost every project we deal with has some software component somewhere into it. In the last fiscal year, IRAP provided funding to a total of 3,657 firms. So what size of companies do we work with? Up to now, what you've heard with respect to emissions reductions in clean tech, the size of the firms or the scale of the firms were quite big, particularly for the last presentation and some of the projects that SIF was working on. We tend to play on the smaller side of the spectrum, much, much earlier stage. A typical IRAP client might be into the market with a first product. They're typically generating revenue when they're working on a second product based on that market insight that they've developed actually being in the market. That can vary by industry sector, of course. Pharmaceuticals will be at one end of the scale in terms of the length of time and how long they've been working on this. Software would be at the other end of that scale. In terms of the number of employees, 84% of the firms that received IRAP funding last fiscal had less than 50 full-time employees. So who can we work with? So basic eligibility to work with IRAP: need to be incorporated. Can't be just an idea with a laptop in a basement. Actually need to be incorporated. For profit, so we don't work with not-for-profits. And you need to be a small to medium-sized enterprise, which is was 499 employees or less, and you're operating in Canada. And the objective that they got is to be able to grow through innovation. So meeting the basic eligibility does not guarantee support. We also assess the business. What's the opportunity? How big is it? What does the company have for leadership and financing to go along with that opportunity? Do they have the potential to execute? What is the company's commercialization plan going forward? So what do we look for in a project? Remember a couple of slides back, I was talking about technical risk. I typically, when I talk to people in southern Alberta, I use an oil patch analogy. So imagine you're a downhole tool company. You've got a suite of tools that you sell or lease into the drilling industry. You don't have a measurement while drilling tool. So you take two engineers, you stick them in a room for 6 months, they design a tool, they build it, they stick it down a hole, it works, and then you add it to your product line. That's probably not enough risk for IRAP. Because when you stuck those two engineers in that room, you kind of already knew what was going to come out the back end. If you flip that over and you look at it from a market side, if your market is Panoka, maybe that's not ambitious enough for IRAP. like you to start in Pinoca. That'd be great. Start in Pinoca, then take over Alberta. And once you've taken over Alberta with that measurement while drilling tool, then you realize that West Texas is a place you need to be. So you get down there. And once you're in West Texas, you realize offshore Nigeria is an opportunity for you as well. We're looking for that combination of technical risk and a large potential for growth. So a big impact for the firm and large potential benefits to Canada. In addition to regular projects, we can help firms with international co-innovation projects. Emissions reduction and clean tech are global by definition. The IRAP international network scheme can help firms find the best fit international programs that Canada has. We have an international co-innovation action plan program that to help IRAP clients prepare for their first international foray. And then IRAP connects them into global value chains through significant advisory, not only with their own ITA, but with their international ITA, and then participation in collaborative R&D programs, such as Eureka, Eurostars, the Canadian International Innovation Program, and Can Export. So, IRAP is about advice and relationships. It's a discretionary program. Not all firms get funded. We're looking for technical risk and large potential for growth. If you get to connect with an IRAP ITA, think about them as an angel investor. An angel investor is not going to write a check the first time you meet them. You're there to build a relationship. How to connect with IRAP? Doesn't matter where you are in the country. The 1-877 number will get you to one of my colleagues or myself across the country, and we'll start a conversation from there.